Tuesday, February 18, 2020, time is 7:15, and the regular scheduled meeting of Greensburg Plan Commission is called to order. At this time, I'd like everyone to silence any electronic devices they might have and stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Complying with Title VI of the Civil Rights Act of 1964, the city requests that participants in this meeting complete a voluntary anonymous survey that is available on the table in the back of the room. This time, John, please do roll call.
Rick?
Here.
Rick, Roy?
Here.
Steve? Kevin?
Here.
Tom?
Here.
Mark?
Here.
Phil?
Thank you. At this time, I will turn the meeting over to Chris Stevens for electing officers for coming here.
Thank you. We will start with President. Do we have any nominations? I welcome the nominations for the President of the Planning Commission for the coming year.
I nominate Kevin Fleetwood.
I'll second. Roy nominated Kevin Fleetwood, seconded by Mark. Kevin, do you accept the nomination?
Yes, sir.
Kevin accepts the nomination. Is there any additional discussion from any Planning Commission members regarding that nomination? Is there any discussion from anyone in the audience that would like to have a statement on that nomination? Hearing none, I would...
I'll move to close the nomination.
Thank you. Second. Nominations are closed. Any discussion on that? Nope. All those in favor of Kevin being the president, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Motion carries, and he is the president. Secretary, do that one next. Do I have anybody who would like to make a... I will open the nominations for secretary.
I'll make John.
John's been nominated. Do I have a second?
A second.
Roy, a second. Nominated, a second. John, do you accept the nomination?
Yes.
Moved, seconded. Any discussions on that? Anybody from the audience that would like to speak on that? Any other candidate nominations? I entertain a motion to close.
I move to close the nominations.
First, second. Mark, seconds. Therefore, all those in favor of John as the secretary, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? There's your president, and there's your secretary. I will now open the floor for nominations for vice president. Would you like to nominate Roy? I have one nomination for Roy. Do I have a second?
Second.
Seconded by Tom. Roy, do you accept?
Yes.
Any other discussions on that nomination? Any members of the public who wish to speak on that nomination? Hearing none on both. Any other nominees? Having hearing none, I would entertain a motion to close nominations.
So moved.
Moved by Kevin, second by Mark. All those in favor of Roy as your vice president, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Passed unanimously. There you go. Now I'm done.
Thank you, sir.
Yep.
Gentlemen, in your packet, you have the minutes from our last meeting, which was November 19th. Take a moment to read through those, please.
Okay.
make that motion.
About a second. Roy made, Gordon seconded. All in favor of the minutes as approved, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign.
Abstain.
And Rick abstained. Thank you, Rick. Minutes approved as presented. Old business, we have none. New business, Mayor Marsh swearing in of all members.
Good evening, gentlemen. As you have a new member and then a couple reappointments this year, we're just going to do oaths of office for everyone. That way we have a sort of documentation when their term started. So if you please stand, raise your right hand, repeat after me. I state your name.
I, Kevin Guzman.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the laws of the state of Indiana.
And the laws of the state of Indiana.
And all local ordinances.
And all local ordinances.
And that I will faithfully and impartially perform.
That I will faithfully and impartially perform.
And discharge the duties of the office.
And discharge the duties of the office.
Of the City of Greensburg's Plan Commission.
The City of Greensburg's Plan Commission.
According to the law and the best of my ability.
According to the law and the best of my ability.
Congratulations, everyone. Look forward to working with you.
Thank you, Mayor.
All right, next, Chris Stephen, non-collusion agreement.
Yeah, I just wanted to kind of update you as to this potentiality. So Sarah, in her kind of new role, and I've been sort of discussing, non-collusion has been proposed by, you know, various individuals, people that she's been talking to, as something that is, you know, we may want to consider. Given the fact that there are people that come in front of this board that would be from various businesses or, you know, things like that, it may be in our best interest to find, you know, some language that works, in which case we would be bringing it to you and asking you all as members of the Planning Commission to sign a non-collusion agreement that basically is saying, look, I as a member am not going to, you know, collude or convert with the individuals that are coming before the board with requests and things like that. It's pretty standard. At this point, I've started doing some research into it. I'm not 100% sure that it's something that we need at this stage, but I think it is probably a belt and suspenders approach that is not unwarranted. I have not yet found language that I really like, so I will either be creating that whole cloth or doing a little bit more research into cases where it's been tested so that I can have language that I really like. So that's an ongoing project that I'm working with Sarah, and I think she just wanted me to update you on what the status of that was. Does anyone have any questions for me with regard to that?
Okay. Sarah, you have anything to update, anything to add to that?
No.
Thank you, Chris. Next item on the agenda, Sarah Hamer, discussion of land usage ordinances.
So I'm here this evening to seek some kind of approval, looking into wanting to clean up, per se, our land usage ordinances and go along the line of a unified developmental ordinance, which a lot of your cities and towns are doing. When you get into our land usage ordinances, you've got tons and tons of, sometimes you end up with more pages of definitions than you do the actual ordinances, and we may use three of those definitions that pertain to what we use on a daily basis, or people getting sign permits or whatever it may be. You could take two or three people that look into to read the ordinance, and we all get something different out of it. They're very hard to understand and follow. So the cleanup and making a unified developmental ordinance just really cleans everything up and puts it in simpler terms. And I believe couple, 3 years ago, it was looked into, or to kind of get started, and that kind of just fell through the cracks. They had had a few meetings and that kind of thing. This will help in the development as we move forward with the city, to simplify things, not only for our developers or local contractors, but just people in the community, to make it more clear and specific of how we do things and how things flow. If we have a contractor that wants to come in and look at one thing specific, boom, it's in this section. Simple to find, simple to read, simple to follow. So I'm in the process of looking for some qualified professional service people to assist us with this. And eventually, hopefully, bring them in to make some proposals in the very near future. Some I've talked to, it could take 4 to 6 months. It's going to involve time on for the Planning Commission side. You know, there might be a couple extra meetings in this process. It'll involve the office, a lot of time with that, forming like a subcommittee of some five, six people tops. And 4 or 5 meetings that, you know, once they start developing, if this is something we go with, and, you know, looking over. But I think for the future and the development of the city down the road, this is going to be something that's needed to be done. And so I'm just here this evening trying to get, like, an okay to proceed with that, and check into with these consultants, and then look at them coming to present to the Planning Commission and proposals in the future.
Well, I, for one, think it's a good idea. The land use ordinances do need to be revised. Years in the past, we tried to set up a committee, meet on certain days, try to start rewriting ourselves, and it just hasn't worked out. My view, I think it's needed, and I think this is a way to approach it where we can get it done in a timely manner.
To do it on your own, it's going to take, or even with a committee of people, a lot of time. Just in getting some idea on time, I've been told from a consulting firm that 4 to 6 months, and I was kind of shocked with that. You know, that that's, you know, doing a good job. They have teams of people, you know, not just one person that would be doing it. So it's things that they do all the time.
When we came into the position of superintendent, we had no policies in place that were in line with federal and state guidelines specifically. We had the option of writing all those policies ourselves or seeking professionals who already had those in line with that we needed. We chose to go the second route, and now we just do twice a year updates of those policies. And I think that's the only way we can do it. You can't put a bunch of individuals together who really don't know what they're doing for the most part and expect to come out with a product that's going to be lasting. I would say this. So I would definitely be in favor of pursuing this.
The other members have any comments or thoughts?
Sounds like a good deal.
Does anyone from the audience have any comments? Having heard none, and based upon feedback from commission members, I'd say proceed with contractors, consultants put together, just a little consensus of proposals, that's what we're looking at.
Okay.
The next item is on the agenda, the executive session on March 25th.
Yeah, and that is where I was thinking that I could bring like three consultants in. I don't know that I want to do an executive session. I want to do a special meeting, and I worded that wrong on there, sorry. So a special meeting, so if there is anything, you know, that we want to decide on that night, or you all want to decide on that night, then we can. Just, you know, if this is a process we're going to start, I just want to keep it flowing, to, you know, make good use of our time and money. So this...
At this point, do you think you'll have, by the 25th, you'll be ready for presentations? Is March 25th at 6 p.m. work for members of the commission?
What we'll do is, you don't have somebody come at 6 when it starts. They'll get 20 minutes if they need to present. You know, then we can say 10 minutes or whatever. We can use 10 minutes of our own time, I guess, for any discussion or any questions we have then. Bring in the next group, same thing, next group, same thing. So, I don't think that would be the only thing that we need to do. Because then after, you know, once the planning commission decides maybe who they want to go with, then we need to go in front of the council and back to get their approval.
Rick, do we need a motion to approve this?
I don't think so. I think you accurately reflected in your as long as the minutes show it's, it would basically just be a motion of confidence. I mean, you can schedule a special meeting anytime. You don't need a motion to do that. You just have to properly notice it. And I do think what Sarah's proposing is the proper method moving forward with it, because it would fall under, in my opinion, professional services. So I don't think we need to do like a bid proposal or anything like that. I think it can just be, you know, two or three different companies that are making a pitch to you, and your recommendation to the council as to which one you want out of those three. And then we'd be able to take it from the council meeting. So, if you wanted to have a motion, you could do a motion of confidence to move forward, but I don't think you need one.
Thank you much. So, let's proceed forward with March 25th at 6 p.m.
Okay. If that would change or something, I'll let everybody know. Thank you.
Do we have any other new business to bring to the commission? Having heard that, I take a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
By Roy, 90 seconds. Second by Mark.